Once the story of Harry Potter ended, many things happened following that. In this video, I'll be revealing every single thing that happened after the series ended, without missing out anything. So keep watching and let's get started. Ginny and Harry continued their passionate romance. At some point, Harry and Ginny were married, and her last name became Potter. She gave birth to three children, James Sirius, Albus Severus, and Lily Luna. After Voldemort took over of the ministry, Kingsley Shacklebolt was eventually made permanent Minister of Magic, and set about writing the Ministry of Corruption and Discrimination. Hermione and Ron were married with two children, Rose and Hugo Granger Weasley. She had several nieces and nephews through her marriage to Ron. Hermione is also the godmother of Harry and Ginny Potter's eldest child, James Sirius. Draco eventually married Astoria Greengrass, the younger sister of fellow Slytherin classmate Daphne Greengrass, who had gone through a similar conversion from pure blood ideals to a more accepting and tolerant way of life. This was something of a disappointment for Lucius and Narcissa, and the two had a son, Scorpius Malfoy. Astoria died during the summer of 2019 due to her blood curse. When Teddy, Lupin and Tonks' son, was born, Remus immediately made Harry Teddy's godfather. His mother and father both fought in the Battle of Hogwarts and died in it, leaving him an orphan, and was therefore raised by his grandmother Andromeda Tonks. Teddy usually spent most of his time with the Potter and Weasley families, who were also distant relatives of his through his maternal grandmother's side of the family. Teddy Lupin did not become a werewolf like his father. He was, however, a metamorphomagus, like his mother, being able to change his physical appearance at will. George never truly got over Fred's death. He eventually married Angelina Johnson, the pretty girl Fred attended the Yellow Ball with, and named his first child Fred in loving memory of his twin brother he lost during the final battle. The couple also had a daughter named Roxanne. George continued to run Weasley's Wizard Wheezes to great success. Harry and eventually Ron joined the Auto Department at the Ministry of Magic, and Hermione became a high-ranking official in the Department of Magical Law Enforcement. Following the war, Bill and Fleur had three children, Victor, Dominic, and Louis Weasley. Victor was born in the anniversary of the Battle of Hogwarts, thus her name which means victory in French. Victor also seemed to have a relationship with Teddy Lupin. As of 2013, Bill was still employed as a curse breaker for Gringotts and had returned to his work in Egypt. As of Fleur, she was granted Medal of Honors from the French and British Ministries of Magic for her actions in the war. Due to their actions during the war, allowing Death Eaters to escape back to Voldemort and joining forces with him themselves, Shacklebolt disbanded the Dementors as guards of the wizard prison. It is unknown where they went or what they did without their only known application. After the Dementors were removed from the prison, others were placed in the prison as guards. Ginny was part of the Quidditch team, the Holy Head Harpies, for several years. She eventually retired and later became the senior Quidditch correspondent for the Daily Prophet. Dudley and Harry remained on Christmas card terms, and Harry sometimes took his children to Dudley's. It is unknown if Dudley ever returned to Littlewinging, or if their family had stayed in the place they were relocated to. By 2020, Dudley's mother had passed away. It was revealed that she keeps the blankets that Harry was brought to her in when he was a baby, which was given back to him after her death. Percy returned to the now reformed Ministry of Magic and became head of the Department of Magical Transportation under new Minister of Magic Kingsley Shacklebolt. Percy eventually married a woman named Audrey, and the couple had two daughters, Molly and Lucy. Hermione went back to Hogwarts and completed her 7th year of study and her NEWTS, while Harry and Ron didn't do that. Mr. Weasley eventually fixed Sirius Black's motorcycle and gave it to Harry. Luna became a famous wizarding naturalist, traveling the world in search of strange creatures. She discovered and classified many species that had never been encountered before. Luna married fellow naturalist Rolf Scamander, grandson of Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them author Newt Scamander. The couple also had twin boys named Lorcan and Lysander. Hagrid survived the event of the war and would still be working at Hogwarts when Albus attended school for the first time. However, as Maxim eventually realized that Hagrid wasn't sophisticated enough for her, Hagrid remained single for the rest of his days. It's likely that his brother Grab remained in the Forbidden Forest and was still cared for by his brother Hagrid. Minerva McGonagall had been officially appointed to the position of headmistress by the Hogwarts Board of Governors 4 months later, by which time the damages done to the castle during the battle had been repaired, and the protective enchantment around the castle and grounds restored. Harry revealed Snape's true intentions and motives shortly before Voldemort's death, and later ensured that Snape portrayed placed and found its rightful place among the school's previous headmasters. Neville's parents, Alice and Frank Longbottom, never recovered. They lived out their lives in St. Mungo's. Harry lost the ability to speak to snakes when the Horcrux inside him was destroyed. Firenze the Centaur was eventually welcomed back into the Centaur herd. Hermione, after the Second Wizarding War, searched for her parents in Australia and returned their memories. They later returned to England with her. Gilderoy Lockhart never recovered from the injuries he sustained in the Chamber of Secrets, thus he remained in St. Mungo's forever. Neville briefly worked as an otter immediately following the war. Sometime afterwards, he was offered a place on the Hogwarts staff with the headmistress Minerva McGonagall and ultimately landed a teaching job at the Herbology Department. Neville also became the head of Gryffindor House after McGonagall went on to be the headmistress. After Voldemort's death, Umbridge was arrested, tried, convicted, and given a life sentence to Azkaban for her crimes against Muggleborns, as not all of them survived. Since a little boy, Ron was really fond of the chocolate cards and had a habit of collecting them, so it seems so fitting that Ron is memorized with his own chocolate frog card. To this date, Ron believes that this is his greatest achievement. Viktor Krum continued his Quidditch career representing Bulgaria in international Quidditch matches until 2002. On the final of that year, Bulgaria suffered a crushing disappointment when outstanding Egyptian seeker beat Krum to the snitch, making them lose. After the match, a tearful Krum announced his retirement. However, Krum's ambition to help Bulgaria win the Quidditch World Cup made him come out of retirement to compete in the 2014 Quidditch World Cup, but his dramatic return caused Bulgaria to attract support from those whose own country had not qualified. He ended up catching the snitch and secured Bulgaria's victory over Brazil in the World Cup final. Bulgaria's success was described by Ginny Weasley as being mostly due to Viktor Krum's excellent performance. Viktor eventually found love with someone from his native Bulgaria. He also kept in contact with Hermione, although the relationship was nothing more than friendship. Lucius, Narcissa and Draco's crimes were forgiven due to their abandonment of Voldemort and his cause, and Narcissa's lie to the Dark Lord that saved Harry's life in the Forbidden Forest. None of them served time in Azkaban due to the evidence Lucius provided against the fellow Death Eaters and his help to ensure the capture of many Voldemort followers who had fled into hiding. Slughorn continued teaching after the Second Wizarding War, and still as the head of Slytherin. His bravery at the Battle of Hogwarts was well publicized and changed the perception of Slytherin for the better. Horace Slughorn retired permanently at some point before 2016 and had the honor of having a portrait of himself placed in the Slytherin common room. Buckbeak survived the battle and was still alive and well by 2008. During a Christmas season at Hogwarts, he stayed with Hagrid, two invited students to ride him around the castle. If you want to watch more of Harry Potter videos, click on this playlist over here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.